Welcome back to Let's Play Disco Elysium Blind. I am Amethyst Lunatari, heading off from the bookstore. We spent about an episode and a half over here. Oh, there's a person just hanging out over there. This coin-operated viewer has been banged up, inoperable. Better watch him. Better mouth your watch around me, boy. Hick! Alright, let's... I'm not going over there yet. We'll look around here. To Capeside Apartments, Martinez Pier. To Roundabout North. Things I've seen. Hick! And said... The ad reads, broken window? Tibbs has windows. If you had a bag in your hand, perhaps you could collect these bottles and sell them. Is that a bag? Coin-operated viewer. No, that's a coin-operated viewer. Facing southwest, its coin slot is full of fossilized bubblegum, rendering the machine permanently inaccessible. Look inside. A thick layer of graffito covers the lenses. You spell out the word Onuk written on the other side, with N and C scribbled backwards. Kuno backwards? Logic says that's Kuno on a lens. Okay, shift your focus to the background. Under the graffito is a set of blurs and... Under the graffito, a set of blurs and grays appears. Behind the water lies a coast studded with concrete and reeds. On it, a church on stilts, lanky, weather-worn wooden planks, an X-shaped cross topping its tower. Encyclopedia says, you know this to be the star of Paracarnassus, or the Chi Rho, the central symbol of the Paracarnassian Church, a star, a great moral height to be strived towards. Okay. Inland Empire says, the church looks old and weather-worn. There are no lights in the windows. Poor little viewer. Pat it. The metal feels cold and wet under your palm. It looks unhygienic. Vandalism. Shaking my head. Probably some kids. Lieutenant inspects the rigged slot. And this one? This coin-operated viewer is facing south. The instruction manual says to insert 25 centimes and pull the handle while looking inside, then use the focus knob to zoom in if necessary. Logic says, why place a tourist attraction in the middle of such poverty? What's a tourist attraction doing here? Kim says, there was a revitalization project in 49. The design studio tried restoring Martinez to its pre-war glory. Lieutenant looks around and concludes, It didn't stick, I think it should be. What happened? They got as far as the street lamps and the statue on that intersection, then something went sour. He lowers his voice. I suspect that something was Everard Clare, the union leader. He muscled them out. It's how it usually goes around here. Can we do something about it? We should have done something about the union 10 years ago. That ship has sailed, officer. I need to save my money still. I wonder how much this goes on for. Should we try talking to this guy? Nothing I can't do. I'm the job for every man. Listen, boy. I don't start trouble. I fix it. Right. What's this? A yellow plastic bag frit. Equip this to collect tear from the streets. Sweet. You hear the distant squall of seabirds. So that's a tool. This plastic bag has frit, spelled incorrectly, written on it in a dynamic, forceful manner that implies great prices. As you crack it open, a malty gust of air flies in your face. Smells of yeast and beer. A perfect place for tear. Tar? Tear? Okay, now apparently we can collect... bags? Come on, hick! The night's still young. Okay, so I guess we need to put that in our hand. Aha! Oh, we're collecting cans. Plastic tear, glass tear. Okay, it's not going to show up here. What if there's a way to tell? There's no way to tell, like, what's in here? Oh, contains two bottles. Okay. So we turn this in at the Fritz store. Well, there's stuff here, too. With two things. Plastic. Okay, cool. Oh wait, there's more. I wonder if there's a limit to how much it can hold. We'll get more. Let's check down by the pier. See what else might be over here. Rhymes. Music is my life, man. Hick. Kim's checking out the scenery. That. A splatter of bullet holes lines the wall. Esprit de Corps says, the sight of bullet holes stirs something in you, making you forget the lieutenant's surname. Look closer first. The fading marks are too degraded to draw any forensic conclusions, just chips in the sandstone. Visual calculus says, they look pretty ancient. Kim, look, bullet holes. Where? He looks around. Point to it. Someone has been shot. We're cops. We should solve it. There? He looks to the wall. Those are old. What do you mean, old? These bullets were fired during the revolution over half a century ago. They do not warrant investigation. Okay. What can you tell me about the revolution? Not much. I don't have a fresh perspective on it. Shall we go?
Sure.
Ten bottles. I guess it was telling us that. Alright, let's make our way back this way. I wonder if there's any bottles and stuff up here. Here's a garbage can. So I don't know how much we can carry or how much we can find, but it could be worth it. We could, maybe we can get enough money to pay our hotel tab. Seems like a good idea. Look, we got one more over here by the carriage. Oh, there's more over here. Talk to these people. Wouldn't even pick it up if my heart wasn't in it.
Life! It doesn't need to be a struggle!
Gaston Martin. He covers his mouth to hide a burp.
Oh, I'll be with you in a moment, officer. Let me just finish my sandwich. Talk to angry old Rene first.
He nods to his partner.
Life! Oh, I'll be...
Okay. Let me look at this first before I talk to the partner. Tire tracks leading onto the roof. The slush and rain has almost washed them off. I had a thought, but it's gone. Did that person cover his head with something? Okay, it's back. The spirited chirps and clicks of swallows fills the air. Look at mayonnaise on the measuring tape.
Have you no shame? Whining about your back every time you bring out the measuring tape?
He's saying to his partner, Rene Arnaud.
Rene, you're a man with a fork in a world of soup. Please, let's just try to enjoy the game, all right?
This one's still chewing on his sandwich.
I am trying to, but you keep breaking my concentration. You're old, I can see that. We're both old. Now, stop grabbing your ass like it's a girl.
Physical instruments, success. These manly men are playing balls. This is a ball game. Grab a ball and play it. Don't ask questions. Shoot first, ask questions never. Shouldn't I ask what game it is first? No, you got this. There's the ball. You're the game. I'm good with hand-eye coordination. Better observe them first.
See? Your munching and complaining have ruined my concentration.
Concentration. The man throws a metal ball towards a smaller wooden ball in the sand, missing it by a meter.
Ah, oh, mon dieu. The pain in my back is unbearable. I can't even say if it's in my back or hip anymore. Feels like it's in both.
He tries to measure the throw.
I hope you pass out from it, you goddamn jellyfish! Men like you are the reason this nation is sinking!
He's not very nice, this guy. Standing tall and proud, he looks at his partner with disgust. Encyclopedia says trying to throw something as close as a predetermined point as possible. Measuring, this must be the age-old game of pétanque. Physical instrument says, shush, ignore them. They don't know what they're doing. They're old. You are letting down yourself and the team. Get in the damn game already. Wait, what team? Does it matter what team? Pick a team, any team, the blue team. You're letting them down. Get in the game and throw the goddamn ball. Why are you so mean to me? Eyes on the ball, dinky winky. Alright, let's grab the ball and show them how it's done. Weren't we better at this before? Plus one, minus one to know the game is pétanque. So I could have done better if I didn't know what the game was. Fail. You're immediately surprised by the ball's lack of weight. No matter, you'll make it work. We had success. Feel the ball. The cold metal ball is surprisingly smooth against your neck. It has a pattern on it. Probably a sponsored ball. Yours would only be covered with bumps of learning and scars of victory. Already your muscles are adjusting to the weight. the nervous system calibrating, until you and the ball have merged into a single entity. The man ball is ready. Take in the surroundings. A chilly breeze ruffles your hair as you stand there, feet firmly planted. All sounds, smells, even the wind, everything fades until the only thing left is the union of man and ball. There's time for a last glance inward. Who am I? An embodiment of pure emotion, a fine-tuned locomotor running at maximum efficiency. Esprit de Corps says, some would say you're still a cop, but I guess we're beyond that now. The inertia can be contained no more than a bullet leaving a gun. Let go. Be the bullet. Be the ball. Oh. I thought we had success. Merde, the old soldier yells in outrage. Bordel de merde. Rhetoric says, yeah, a whorehouse of crap. Visual calculus says, it wasn't whorehouse of crap. That shot was at least 23 meters, probably 24 and then some. Nothing to be embarrassed about. What the hell is your problem? Rene says. Not a weak right triceps, that's for sure. I don't care if you are a cop, you do not just ruin someone's game. It's so goddamn disrespectful. I'm sorry. You vandalize our game, son. He tries to calm himself. We can't play petanque with five bulls. Oh, petanque, I understand. No, you don't. Our petanque game is ruined. He's getting angry again. We want our boule back. Gaston says, take it easy, Rene. The jolly one tries to defuse the situation. This is just a misunderstanding, isn't it, officer? No harm done. Rene says, of course there's harm done, you orange slug. The heel of his cavalry boot slams in the ground. You owe us a goddamn boule. Okay, I will try to fix this. New task, replace lost boule. Good, Rene says. He nods. Mistakes are forgiven when men at least try to right their wrongs. I believe you will try. Now, why did you approach us? Rhetoric says, yes, why did you come here? It's unlikely they know anything about the murder. Logic says, you never know. He might know something. This is a good vantage point. Do you know anything about the man hanged in the backyard of Whirling and Rags? Unfortunately, I don't, he shrugs. Unlike most of the locals, I have no qualms about assisting law enforcement, but this affair has passed me by completely. And most of the locals? In Martinez, the union is the law, so can you really blame them? But you don't have a problem with cops? Cop is a pejorative term. I don't have a problem with policemen. On the contrary, I admire the effort to bring order to our streets. Rhetoric says he doesn't know about the crime. Your time is better spent discussing politics. What about police women? I'm confident they are indispensable in regard to all the paperwork and other administrative duties. There are no duties RCM women couldn't carry out. But you must agree that nature, in her infinite wisdom, has made men more fit to perform certain more challenging tasks, don't you, officer? No, I don't think there's any evolutionary inequality at play here. Really, officer? He smirks. Match an average woman against an average man in dark alley and see who comes out on top. Gender equality is very noble, a very modern idea, but in real life, primal roles prevail. But I do not wish to discuss this matter further. You seem to be playing in a crater. Yes, the man nods. The terrain here provides an interesting variety to a familiar game. Do you know what created it? I do, he nods, straightening his back. Fire from heavy artillery. Okay, it's a crater left by artillery fire, but why? Why what? Why was heavy artillery used? Because that's what happens when communards hijack your country execute your supreme leadership and turn your capital into a slaughterhouse, you use heavy ordnance to clean up your home. Wait, who are the communards again? Commies, communists, socialists, anarchists, call them what you like, they just chose the name to feel special. The carabineer frowns. Senseless sentimentality. Did you use artillery fire against them? Sadly, no. It was the foreigners who brought them to their knees. We fought valiantly. Too valiantly. So valiantly we got licked, he adds, squeezing a boule in his fist. Should have fought dirty, like they did with their suicide sex cult propaganda and mad anarchist women strapped to shrapnel bombs. We didn't, though, and we lacked caliber. God bless him, but the Suzerain's cannons simply weren't big enough. Logic says it was probably a bit more complicated than that. I'd bomb this place too. Why shell them here in Martinez? Because this place is the damn beachhead, he says, pointing to the bay. Had to soften the commies up first. The beachhead? Yes, he nods, inspecting you with some disdain. The military-coordinated amphibious landing to take back Revachol. Martinez was used as one of the three footholds in Revachol during Operation Deathblow in 08. The other two were off in Stella Maris and the Delta. He points to the northeast. Deathblow. Sounds grim. This here is blood ground, where Coalition boots first made landfall and cleaned those rabid dogs out. Most likely, he says, looking down at the soil, we're playing petanque on their mangled corpses. Gaston says, blood ground. He shakes his head. You've got old Rene going there, like he isn't angry enough already. Hold on, the Coalition? He grunts. Don't get me wrong, officer. I hate those foreign dogs, but the enemy of my enemy and all that, they're the lesser evil. Is that why everything is so bombed out? Damn right, son. They laid the fire of hell on this city before they stormed it, and it worked out, too. There was a strange gleam in his eyes. The rest of the city got cleaned up, but Martinez they keep as a monument. A dark shadow runs across his face, and now the Union Socialists are practically running the place. Gaston says, well, it's your own damn fault. You, we, the Coalition, Revachol, whatever you want to blame, who never finished the job. Officially, the party never surrendered. Of course, they still hold influence. You don't even begin to truly understand the players on the table, let alone the specific circumstances surrounding the... He stops mid-sentence and turns to you. What do you think? Rhetoric says, thinking men have opinions on these things. Present one. This Coalition seems quite capable, actually. They're not. And I'm sorry it had to be them. After 8 years of fighting those hyenas, boiling cats for food and drinking piss in the mountains? He takes a deep breath. I would have preferred if the Right Honorable King Guillaume returned to Revachol, or even if that damn clown, Frissel, had risen from the grave and led us. Sadly, that was not the case. Empathy says, this royal failure weighs heavily on him. Instead, all that is just, holy, and beautiful in the world was wiped away, and now it's neon signs with toothpaste ads everywhere, foreign influence peddling garbage and stupid music on the radio. This is just what the commies wanted. This was their plan all along. This is what they wanted to replace the rule of suzerain with. Who is this Frissel? Damn Frissel, he was the king we couldn't protect. The carabineers failed him, and the crown. The old veteran falls silent and massages his chest. He died in the hands of Hoi Polloi in a very public execution. You mentioned Guillaume? A true king in both blood and mind. Led Revachol before Frissel, or Frissel, he would have been better, but the damn commies drove him into exile. Drama says, some manner of self-deceit is present in his thinking. Sounds like this Guillaume abandoned him, and he doesn't want to admit it. What exactly is a suzerain? Conclude. The suzerain is the king, Has everyone forgotten already? He then slowly nods and says to himself, they've forgotten already. It's no use talking to you. You were still in Daddy's balls when it happened, when we took our last stand against the filth and rode the cavalry straight into gunfire. Alright, thank you for your time. I'm gonna not do this yet. So now will this guy talk to us, Gaston?
Oh, I have really outdone myself. This is divine.
He takes a bite out of his sandwich.
Yes, that's what you need, Gaston. More padding on that fat ass of yours. I hope your heart gives out.
He's really nasty to Gaston. What the hell?
Rene, it's the little pleasures. Life doesn't need to be a struggle. Oh, hello, visitor. How might I be of assistance on this fine day?
He turns to us. A bite of that. Tell me, what do you know about the dead man? Let me think. He looks at the clouds wistfully. I heard someone was hanged and left on a tree for a week, but that's all I know, really. Really? You know absolutely nothing? No, officers, I'm sorry, and I really would like to assist, he adds, smiling apologetically. You are both good guys, I can see that. Rene says, then help them, you wimp. Reproach fills his eyes. You rub plenty of shoulder with this gauche caviar in the Union. Someone must know something. Rhetoric says he means caviar socialists. I wish I could, Gaston says, but I just don't know anything. His cheeks turn red. I always keep my nose clean and don't gossip. Everyone knows and respects that. Drama says, odd, he doesn't seem to be lying, but there's something off here. Sounds like a bit like you're holding back. I'm not, he assures you. I'm not even any... Of course he's holding back. The carabiner crosses his arms. His mouth is so full of union prick he can't even speak properly. Can I at least finish my sentence before you piss on it? Is that okay, Rene? His eyes are furious. I'm not anyone important in the union. I just know Everart. How do you know Everart? Everyone in Martinez knows the Clare brothers, he says solemnly. I taught these boys human studies and history in the gymnasium. Rene says, what do you know about history? The carabiner snaps at Gaston. You never witnessed history, only heard about it. Years later, when it had already moved on, you don't know history. The old soldier mumbles something under his breath and turns to face the sea. There he stands, proud, rigid, and alone, like a cracking marble statue. Kim says, let's try not to get caught in the... He lowers his voice. Crossfire. Esprit de Corps says, lest we leave riddled with bullet holes, this animosity is ancient. Are you a union member? Oh, his cheeks turn red again. In many ways, yes, like an honorary member. I attend meetings and parties, help with little things. Everard, Edgar, and the older Debardiers all know me. So you're not an actual member? Not in a technical sense. His eyes fix on the bulls in the crater. I don't have a vote on or a membership card, but Everard keeps me on the payroll, just for the little things. So that's what it was before. Him hiding something. He tries to make it look like he's a big deal in the Union, and now the illusion is disintegrating before your and Renee's eyes. Logic says he doesn't know anything because no one tells him anything. He's an outsider. Rene says, of course he's not a member. He's not a member of anything. I knew that. He frowns. He's a weather wane. Turns to where the wind blows and tries to look important. I hate the socialist rabble, he continues, but even siding with them is better than living your entire life on the fence, never committing to anything. Pick a damn side already. What are the little things you do for Everart? Writing work, mostly, he smiles. Occasionally he needs something written, and I happen to have a way with words, people say. What kinds of things do you write for him? Oh, nothing official, I assure you. Just essays for the newspapers about Martinez and how things are and how they could be. Everard and I have these long talks where he tells his little pen man exactly what to say, Rene says. It's commie propaganda, plain and simple. You should be ashamed of yourself. Are you a caviar socialist? The old man starts laughing. I don't even consider myself a regular socialist. Politics is not really something I involve myself in, officer. Wait, how can you write those newspaper pieces if you're not political? Officer, I have a vivid imagination, he laughs again, and like I said, I have a way with words. That's enough. No need to sink in politics. Rhetoric says he just fluffs it up. Of course, Rene says, don't sink into anything. Don't sink into any fight. Only sink into your couch. But you need to believe in something. Freedom, the people, Revachol, or even money. I believe everyone has the right to think and do whatever they want, even if it's nothing at all. I'm very adaptable. Mon Dieu, the carabineer closes his eyes like he's never going to open them again. All right. That's all for now. No, thank you, Gaston nods, smiling wide, for being consummate professionals. You'll have this case wrapped up in no time. Looks delicious, pointing to the sandwich. Can I have a bite of that? I'm sorry, officer, but I really don't share food, he says and quickly adds. Nothing personal, just a principle. The only one you have, Rene says. Okay, I'm not that hungry anyway. Oh, that's good. That's very good. He's visibly relieved. You must have other business, then? Why do I want his sandwich so bad? Never mind. Tasks. Replace lost boule. Due to some confusion over the game Rene and Gaston were playing, you threw one of their patonk boules far in the sea. The shot was excellent, but now you owe them a boule, or at least something similar, at least similar-looking metal sphere. Stop complaining and hurry up. Let me go look over here really quick before we call it an episode. Let's see what this is. Enormous bulls worthy of a real man. Alright. Yes, yes, the good old days. The all-or-nothing days. Alright, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode. And always, seek adventure.